Hero pools are being removed from Overwatch forever. All right, guys, welcome to the channel. So I put this question out to you guys on the community tab on the YouTube channel. And this is what I said. Hero pools are being removed from Overwatch indefinitely. Do you agree with this? Explain. Oh, I've said you. I meant your, ladies and gentlemen, your vote. And you could appear in a video. They'll still be used at our level, but with some changes, 2-week-long rotations, etc. And I've linked to my tweet, which then links to all the other stuff. But we'll go over that in this video, so don't worry. So what we've got here is a poll which took place 20 hours ago. It got 21,000 votes, which is absolutely insane. And check this, everything's insane. I know everything's insane, but it's just, it's like a crap meme, isn't it? It's like, yeah, Sty says it's insane. It's huge. It's massive. Oh, baby. I don't know where this video is going. Anyway, look at the vote percentage. I agree, hero pools were bad. 75% of the votes, and only 25% disagree and say, no, they were good for the game. So what do you guys think? Well, let's break down the responses and go into detail because this is going to be absolutely beautiful. But before we do that, let's take a look at what the changes actually are. We have a new update to share regarding hero pools. We've been listening to your feedback and constantly iterating on the feature behind the scenes. We initially implemented hero pools to address issues with stagnating metas to keep matchups exciting and fresh. However, we found that the introduction of experimental card and increased hero balance updates has helped us work towards a healthy, changing meta in competitive play without needing to disable heroes. Going forward, we've decided to make the following changes to hero pools starting immediately. Hero pools will be removed indefinitely from competitive play with no tentative date for re-implementation. Beginning June the 13th, the Overwatch League will utilize a single hero pool for the first 2 weeks of each tournament cycle, which consists of 3 weeks of qualifier matches and a tournament weekend featuring bracket play. Hero pools will not be used for the week before each tournament or during tournament bracketed play. Read more information here, and I'll show you guys that in a second. We appreciate your continued feedback and thank you for all of your patience as we've iterated on hero pools. So for Overwatch League, this is what we've got. With the calendar set for the rest of the regular season, we are adjusting hero pools a final time for the 2020 season after consulting with Overwatch League teams and players. Hero pools in Overwatch League will now last 2 weeks before rotating. After each 2 week hero pool period, the next 2 weeks, including the tournament matches, will be played with no hero pool in effect. The next hero pool with Echo, Sombra, D.Va, and Brigitte removed will be in effect for week 19 and 20 of the Summer Showdown qualifier matches. Week 21 will be the same as the tournament, played with no hero pool in effect. The same format will be used for the third regular season tournament and qualifier matches with a new hero pool in effect for 2 weeks of qualifiers, then no hero pool for the third week and tournament matches. The final 2 weeks of the regular season schedule will also operate under a single hero pool. The 2020 playoffs, like the tournaments, will be played without a hero pool. Okay, big, big stuff there. So this was my tweet. This was as the news dropped. Throw the tweet out because I love doing this because you get a lot of people having pretty good discussions in the comments on Twitter, which I know, Twitter generally isn't the best place for discussions, but you do get some pretty interesting gems every now and again. So I said, hero pools have been removed from Overwatch indefinitely and linked to it, and that's all juicy. So what replies did we actually get to this? Keating Theo says, hero pools allowed some metas to be very strong. For example, when Widow, McCree, and Soldier was banned, Pharmacy was amazing because of lack of hitscan. I don't think anyone can disagree with that, and this was happening a lot. McCree and Widow were getting banned a lot of the time, and this meant heroes like Pharah, like Echo, became super strong. And then Echo started to get banned all the time, and then Reinhardt was getting banned all the time. And oh dear. So this is a fair comment, I agree. Rai says, because what people do now is just not going to play for the week. If you let the players choose who to ban, then there will be a ban meta. Roll queue already don't help that much, at least in plat to low diamond games. People still play DPS Moira or soft throw with Hammond or Hog. Now, they did actually change the way the hero pool system works. So it would only affect players in masses and above. Only they never really got a chance to sort of look at that because they've now got rid of the entire system altogether. So they kind of were addressing that. So they were aware of that. But the first line of this comment makes total sense to me. people just probably wouldn't play for the week. If your heroes are banned, I mean, you're just not going to play, right? Because you're not going to go and learn another hero. Overwatch is like 4 years old. You've probably got loads of time, let's say, into Tracer. Tracer gets banned. What are you going to do? Go and play like Genji. You might not even be able to play Genji. You know what I mean? I don't know. But yeah, I agree with this comment. It's a good comment. Okay, let's move on to the comments on the actual poll on the community tab for the YouTube channel. Because there was like 500 and something comments. It was insane. And like I said, 21,000 votes. And like I always say, everything is absolutely insane. So let's get stuck into this because these comments are pretty good. So what I've tried to do is pick some of the most upvoted comments and also look for comments which give like the other side of the point of view. Because I don't just want to sit here reading off comments that are like, yeah, hero pools were terrible. Get rid of them. Because for every... Hero pools were an interesting concept, let's say. They had some pros and they had some cons. So you have to look at the argument from two different points of view. You can't just slam it and go, they're terrible, get rid of them. Overall, I think they were not great. And Blizzard did try to make some changes to address that. Things like restricting them to masters and above. But still, yeah, it's not ideal, is it? You want to play the heroes you want to play. Blizzard stopping you playing your heroes is never going to be a good idea. Okay, let's get stuck into this. So Actual Noobish says, for bad or worse, hero pools were definitely interesting. It's a simple comment, but a lot of people seem to agree with this. And yeah, it was an interesting experiment, I suppose you could say. Now, the official explanation Blizzard gave is, okay, we're balancing the game faster, so we don't really need these hero pools anymore. So that's almost an admission that hero pools were there to stop maybe super OP, well, I don't want to say super OP, but like super oppressive or really strong heroes from being played by physically just removing them from the game. It's like a band-aid fix, but it arguably does work. Obviously, it has other ramifications. Like if you're like the Doomfist player and you can't play Doomfist that week, you feel a bit miffed. You don't really want to play Overwatch, right? So you got all of this kind of stuff going on. But yeah, I agree with this. For better or for worse, hero pools were definitely interesting. They were, and Blizzard have got rid of them. So yeah. Ben Starsky says, it just shows how unbalanced the game is if one hero is being played so often that they have to ban them entirely to change the meta every week. It also messed with SR, as personally, if one of my mains was banned, I would just not queue for that role for the entire week until the ban is lifted, which is not what Blizzard had in mind. And I'm sure that is, you know, I'm sure that is the case. Blizzard want you to play Overwatch. At the end of the day, Blizzard is a games company that runs a lot of games as a live service. You see that phrase everywhere. It just means a game that's constantly evolving. It's online only, typically, and all of that stuff. That's what Blizzard do. You know, look at all their games, Hearthstone, WoW, Overwatch, maybe StarCraft, a slight exception, but even that, I mean, no, that's the same. So they want you active. They want you on their platform playing their games, right? That's what they want you to do. So if they make a change that stops you playing the game, that's a massive no-no. So they're going to have to revert that change. Now, maybe it's just as simple as that. Maybe that's why Hero Pools went away. But I don't think it is, because if that was the case, they would never have implemented Hero Pools in the first place, because they knew it would stop people who one-trick and main characters from being able to play those characters. I think the more interesting part of this comment is very much the fact of the unbalanced game is if one hero is being played so often that they have to ban them entirely to change the meta every week. Now, change the meta every week, I think that's the key phrase here. I think what Blizzard did is they wanted to change the meta frequently because they realized through all the years of Overwatch, and we've found this as players of the game ourselves, where when we're going through like Mercy meta, Moth meta, Dive meta, Goats, all of these kind of different metas that show up, Double Shield, etc., we get bored of them after a certain amount of time. No meta will last forever and just be great to play all of the time. Things need to change. So I think what Blizzard have done is arguably come in with a sledgehammer and gone, you know what? We're going to change the meta all the time now. So enjoy it. Boom. The meta is different every single week. What are you going to do about that now? You can't moan to us now about having static stale metas. That's not really the answer though, is it? The answer is through balancing the game and updating the heroes, introducing new heroes as well more frequently, which I think honestly is a I don't want to say a major failure, but I think it's something I sort of wish Blizzard were faster at, or maybe plan to introduce more heroes in the lifespan of Overwatch, because of course we're reaching the end, we believe, of Overwatch 1's lifespan going into Overwatch 2. Of course we'll get a load of new heroes for Overwatch 2 and all that stuff, but I think adding more heroes more frequently shapes up that, or changes the meta, shakes it up faster, and maybe that's something that Blizzard probably could have done with hindsight. I don't know. Obviously it takes a long time to make new heroes though and all that stuff, especially to the quality that Blizzard produced the characters to. So yeah, I agree with this comment. I think this is a great comment. Nice one, Ben. Peyton says, I mean, when you played the same couple of heroes for years, You just can't learn a new one in that week, not in the same level. It's never going to work the way hero counters are designed in the game. For example, even if I know how to use plenty of DPS, let's say my best hero Ashe is banned, no problem. I could play Reaper, Doomfist, Junkrat, Genji. But what if the enemy comp has Pharah? My McCree and Widowmaker sucks. If my Ashe was always my sniper of choice, why would I practice another? And this is fair. Like, you can see a lot of people agree with this comment, and I think this is totally fair. The major issue with hero pools was the restriction of you playing your character of choice. If they ban that character, then what? It almost feels like a slap in the face, right? It's like, oh, hang on, I've put like 1,000 hours into Pharah and you've banned her. What the hell, Blizzard? What am I supposed to do? And I think that's where a lot of people disagreed with hero pools, and it probably was one of its major issues, to be honest. So again, great comment, Peyton. Nathan is cool, says, at first they were pretty cool. He would say cool, wouldn't he? Bringing Overwatch to the same level as other games that offer hero limitations to shake up the style of play or the playstyle. However, like most things, it's only fun when it doesn't happen to you. Sure, get Tracer and Widow out of here, but once you touch my sweet Reinhardt, you've taken it too far. Seriously though, they got annoying real quick. Now, the thing with this comment, again, a highly upvoted comment, is other games have got a lot more heroes, and I assume that he's referring to MOBA games, Dota, League of Legends, that have pick ban phases at the start of a game. Yeah, I mean, there's hundreds of heroes in those games, or champions in Dota, in League of Legends. Overwatch doesn't have that many, so you can't really maybe do that. I mean, if Overwatch had 100 characters, then yeah, let's go pick ban phase. But, like, is that what Blizzard want to do? I guess you could say historically, especially with the introduction to hero pools. I mean, I'd be super interested to know what actually led them to thinking hero pools was the way forward. Is it almost externally looks like Blizzard are trying to control the direction of the meta through selection or bans of heroes, which force it into different directions. Maybe it's like too controlling of Blizzard if that's where they came from. I'm not saying they have done that, because who knows? I don't think we'll ever know. But yeah, again, good comment. CrashBang85 Gaming says, I really enjoyed the change each week, especially when a strong hero for the skill level was removed. It forced weekly metas and promoted team play even more, which is what Overwatch is surely about. Oh, yeah, you see, this is the thing, right? While it's bad in one way, in another way, it does force... Like, you've got this idealistic view of Overwatch, right? Which is, hey, we can play every hero. We flex to take on whatever the enemy team comp is. But does that realistically manifest in any game that you play? It really doesn't. When you're playing Overwatch, you may be... Like, so if I'm playing a tank, right? Maybe, let's say I start off with Reinhardt, but our team, they want to play Dive. But okay, cool. I can swap to Winston. So I can play those two heroes, and that's great. But that's... Like, I don't know. Like, maybe that's just the type of player that I was, thinking, okay, I want to learn these different tank characters. But when you start introducing the bans, and it prevents you from playing the hero that you've played for so long, then maybe you don't play. Or you see a lot of comments while people are saying, like, oh yeah, there was a lot of ball just throwing matches. This is because maybe their hero was banned. So they're like, you know what, I don't want to play Sigma. I don't want to play Orisa. So I'm just going to play ball. And like, our team don't have a main tank. Stuff like that happens. And I think that's happened throughout the history of Overwatch. And it's a complex issue, but I don't know, like, they did set out to change the meta every week, and that did work, but they restricted usage of people's characters, which I think just sent people off the deep end and really turned people off from playing Overwatch, which obviously is a big no-no. So again, good comment there, CrashBang, I like it. Sebastian says, I actually like the bans. It made it so I had to play heroes out of your comfort zone, but the thing that makes me want it gone is the results in Overwatch League, because it's always the same heroes banned again. Okay, so there's a little bit of Overwatch League here. And to be honest, there's hardly any Overwatch League comments on the poll, which kind of goes to show you that Blizzard probably needs to do a bit more to get people interested into Overwatch League again. I try to do as best as I can, like with the videos that we make, highlighting pro plays and stuff like that. It's actually, there's a lot of changes for the Summer Showdown. Again, going back to the tournament format, which makes it more hype to watch. So I recommend you guys watch that when it comes out. I'll continue to make videos on it and stuff. But yeah, so, I mean, Sebastian liked the bans. And yeah... But this, again, I think just comes down to the mentality of the player. Now, I'm not saying that it's a bad mentality to just want to play one hero. Because think about the way humans work, right? You want to get good at something, right? And you focus on it and you work towards that goal. And that's awesome. this is a completely mental example, but imagine you're a scientist, right? And you're out there and you're working hardcore on physics. I don't know what branch of physics you're working on. Let's just say it's physics, in all of physics. You know all of physics, right? You're a hero. You're working on it for ages. And then in rolls in somebody and goes, you know what? Today we're doing biology. And you're like, excuse me? I'm like, I know everything about physics, but I know nothing about biology. That's kind of what happens with the bans, right? And I think it takes a very, very, there's a very small minority of players that go, you know what? I'm going to try and play a bunch of heroes. And I'll be totally honest with you guys. I'm not that person. Like, I'm honestly, I am the person that will just pick a character and get really good with the character. Well, not one, maybe one or two characters. I mean, I guess my initial approach was to get good with a character in each role and then have like a secondary character. So, you know, I've got a bunch of characters I can play, but I'm not good at every single hero. The thing is, though, through my YouTube channel and covering Overwatch, I was kind of forced to play every single character. Some characters I'm terrible with. Like, Genji is by far my worst DPS like hero by an absolute mile. Like, I'm so bad with Genji because I'm used to playing Hitscan, and Genji just, like, just screws my brain. Like, my brain's not wired for that. But you see what I'm saying, guys? Like, I was forced to do that through content I was making, but I think almost everybody, and even me, would be this way, would try and specialize in one type of hero, and that would be it. Whether that would just be playing my Tracer all the time, or, you know, whether it's somebody playing Ana all the time, and maybe they play a bit of Moira on the side. So, yeah, I don't know. I just don't think there's enough players in Overwatch. Again, I think this is idealistic view that the player base are going to play all the heroes and love them all and swap to what the enemy are doing, and that just has never happened in the history of Overwatch. Ahmed says, I don't mind them being removed, as my mains Batiste and Winston were ever really banned, maybe a couple of times, but I can understand if you're widow main, and how frustrated it can be being able to play for 1 week and then either taking a break for a week or potentially risking the loss of SR. Fine comment. Again, you can see got a decent amount of upvotes. Yeah, I agree with it, Ahmed. Rama says, overall for me, it was the best thing that happened to Overwatch. It really made people take a look at actual counters and team compositions. For example, when McCree and Sombra were banned at the same time, it created the Doom meta. It was nice coming into the game every week and having that variation. Sure, it was annoying when your main got banned, but then it created a completely new meta for a week or two. Now, there is more to this comment, but I think this kind of sums it up. This, I think, is the very idealistic view that Blizzard had for Hero Pools, and I think this is what they were trying to do. I think they put a bit too much faith in the player base being like, hey, we're all going to play every hero, and oh, you've banned my main. It doesn't matter. I'm going to go and learn another hero. But the thing is, you've played your main for 4 years if you got Overwatch at launch. So I don't think you can play another hero to the same level. Now, sure, stuff like map knowledge and comp knowledge and meta knowledge and all that stuff, obviously that's going to transfer over. But if you're playing a Reinhardt and then I say, oh, yeah, by the way, you've got to play Hammond as an example, you're going to be like, what? That's like completely different, you know? So, yeah, I don't know. Like, but this, I think, is where Blizzard were coming from. And you can't blame them for it. Right? It's totally, you know, whatever. And finally, this comment, because this one kind of annoyed me. I've got to be honest. So Tyler Chestnut, that old Chestnut, says, hero pools are a lazy way of getting rid of hard-to-balance heroes. Now, I don't agree with calling developers of any game lazy because they work like crazy. One thing I know, I mean, I know this. I've got a very specific sort of experience here. Like, I've been to Blizzard's head office a lot. I've seen developers at events and all stuff like that. These guys live and breathe Overwatch. They are the most hardcore of Overwatch fans ever. Like, they know everything. It's not like they're just rolling into work and going, oh yeah, let's do this, and then they leave. Oh no, they live and breathe and probably die this game. You know, like, it is insane how much effort they put into this. Way more than any, like, even your favorite YouTuber, streamer, whatever. These guys are living and breathing Overwatch. So I don't think it's lazy of them. I think what they were trying to do was introduce a system that shakes up the meta, that makes the game refreshing to play on a weekly basis, that they were hoping would help people learn different heroes and get good in that kind of way. But obviously it backfired. Now, what we've got to say is this. Blizzard constantly iterated on hero pools. They did not just give us hero pools and go, that's it, deal with it. They made change after change after change after change, then they got rid of it. If that is not Blizzard reacting to the community in a positive way, I don't know what is. They could have just left Hero Pools and gone, whatever, deal with it, but they didn't. They dealt with it and they got rid of it, and arguably it's going to make the game better for it, just because we are getting much faster balance updates, which do change the game in a more positive way, in a more natural way, and surely that's the best way going forward. thank you guys to everybody who took part in this. There was over, well, thanks to everyone who voted. 21,000 votes is crazy. Over 500 comments as well. Thank you guys for commenting. It's always awesome to go through the comments. Obviously, I can't put all of you in the video, as the video will be like 10 hours long. Can't do that. As much as I'd like to do that, I can't do that, ladies and gentlemen. But thank you. And we will continue to do more stuff like this, because I think this is so cool to get into the minds of the community. Because it's all right me just reading stuff and going, oh, yeah, this is what I think. I want to know what you guys think, right? Because the game has got a massive community, and we've all got to get together and just, yeah, it's awesome. Thank you guys for watching. And as ever, make sure you wash your hands, you filthy gits, and I'll catch you lovely lot on the next video. Toodaloo.